When I made Raja Hindustani and it achieved the box office success it achieved, I had two persons to thank. One was God and one was Shri Raj Kapoor. I take his name after God because really I learned watching his cinema, studying every little detail of what it is which makes a filmmaker make the masses of this country, and not only this country, cross the boundaries of this country. People who don't know the language of Hindi swinging to Awara Hu in Russia. Internationally, people going crazy, comparing a Raj Kapoor to a David Lean. And I saw the magic of Raj Kapoor, his music, his great moments, his dramatism, his beautiful Barsaat. And above all, the great presentation of the leading lady or the heroine. Whether it was Aag, Barsaat, Shri 420, Jis Desh Mein Ganga Behti Hai, or Sangam, the heroine was the greatest in the Raj Kapoor film. And talking about Sangam, the cult film, the greatest was, of course, the legendary Vaijayanti Mala Ji.
Oh, Mehbooba, oh, Mehbooba, oh, Mehbooba.
Who we are so fortunate and honored to have with us right now. Namaste, Vaijayanti Ji. I'm too excited and too honored to be a part of this great historic moment. I cannot believe that God has given me this opportunity to share the same platform at RK Studios with an artist and a star of your caliber. Today, when you're sitting over here, may I please ask you with folded hands, what do you think of Sangam? What are the memories crossing you at RK Studios about Sangam?
Well, it brings back nostalgic memories, and I'm visiting RK Studios after, I think, nearly 37 years.
Oh my God.
That's a long time. It was in the early 60s, I think, when Sangam started in 62, and it went on to 63 and got released in 64. Well, I have beautiful memories of Sangam because it was a very, very interesting movie and a very interesting role for me. Well, it started this way. I was working in another Hindi movie being shot at Madras called Nazrana, in which Raji and I were teamed together. And we were on location shooting at the Mahabalipuram beach. And during the shots, when they were arranging the other, the camera and all for the next shot, Raji looked at me and said that, you are my ideal Radha. And for my next film, Sangam. So, will you be Radha? So I didn't know what to say, So I said, well, my grandmother and father are the deciding factors. Mm. So I think you should speak to them. And he did. Mm. He talked to them, and of course, they were very happy and very pleased at the thought of my working under the RK banner. And the great master showman, to be directed by him in an RK film. And I was happy too. So that was it. Then the shooting of Nazrana got over and he went back. And I was busy with some other shooting going on there in Madras. And after, I think, within a week's time or so, what do you think? I get a telegram, you know, what it's, I mean, it read something like this. Bol Radha Bol, Sangam Hoga Ke Nahi.
My God.
I was so amused, you know, to see the telegram in my hands. And I said, I mean, it was very funny sort of, you know, because, well, then I wanted to sort of send a reply. And you know what the reply was? Zarur, no, Sangam Hoga or Zarur Hoga.
Wow.
Oh, that was too funny. And then, of course, everything happened, and we came to Bombay, and then he took my, you know, how he wanted his Radha to be absolutely vivacious, lively, you know, bubbling,
magic,
and highly sophisticated, charming, intelligent, and all that. That was Radha. And there was hardly any makeup. Simplicity was, you know, and he preferred white, of course, as usual. And for that, he left the sort of the saris or the whatever outfit that I would wear. Yeah. Mostly it was saris and salwar kameez. So, of course, they were all in white.
Yeah.
And I enjoyed doing that role. Of course, in the beginning, you know, I was not quite used to Raji's way of working.
Which was what?
And of course, he was different in Nazrana because that was not his own film.
Yeah.
So that made all the difference.
Yeah.
And this was his own film, his own production, you know. So here, that passion in him and workaholic, you know, that like absolutely steeped in it.
Yes.
That was it. And he was. Maybe a little demanding, you know, at times, a hard taskmaster. Mm-hmm. But it didn't take me long to understand his style of work, his way of, you know, and how he wanted me to speak, how he wanted me to stand, and how he wanted me to look, and even how he wanted me to come, you know, climb down the steps, you know, like a whiff of fresh air. Mm. So that was it.
Magic, is it?
And it was very beautiful because it had all the emotions, and you know, it was a triangle, as everybody knows, and one girl and in love with one man, but gets married to another
man,
whom she tries to love after marriage, and then of course the other man sacrifices because they're being best of friends, and so it had a lot of variations and in the emotional sense also, and I think it was very nice. And most important was, I think, for the first time in a Hindi film, you know, this sort of beautiful, picturesque, scenic locations that were shot abroad.
Yes.
And, you know, the beauty, Europe was exposed very
beautifully. Was that the first time you shot abroad? Was that the first time you shot abroad for a
film?
Yes,
first time for me too.
All right.
And first time for a Hindi film.
Yes.
And I think he had an eye for beauty, he had an eye for, and he knew the pulse of the audience. He knew what exactly to give them, you know, that popular appeal.
Absolutely.
And yes, not only that, and but there was also, you know, that artistic, you know,
yes,
that in his way of his shots and the framing and the angles that, you know,
aesthetic.
He used to take a lot of pains.
Yes.
And discuss with Radhu Karmakar, and he knew exactly what he wanted. And the other thing was his remarkable sense of music. You know, his sense of rhythm, his sense of timing, it was amazing. And I have watched him, you know, sit for hours with Shankar Jaikishan, and you know, and wanting a particular melody, and it would keep on, you know, revolving in his mind, and till he you know, he was satisfied, he was not giving up. So I have seen all that, and the meticulous way
DJ
that you know, he worked.
Music. हर दिल जो प्यार करेगा, बोल राधा बोल संगम होगा कि नहीं। ओ मेरे सनम दो जिस मगर एक जान है हम, दोस्त दोस्त ना रहा ये मेरा प्रेम पत्र पढ़कर।
And the most beautiful song, which is my, of course, which my is favorite, is which was shot in Ooty, and he was very particular that I, you know, my white sari with red border. Very particular about that. And ye mera prem patra.
Oh, you like that the most?
Naraz na hona.
Beautiful. That was shot in Ooty, is it?
That was shot in.
It looks like a foreign country.
Yeah, it was like a painting on celluloid. It was so beautiful, very artistically done.
And there is a part at the end of Ye Mera Prem Patra, which you sing in Lata Ji's voice.
Yes.
And at the end, it pans down from the trees.
That's right.
And you're singing.
That's right.
You know, ki tum meri zindagi ho, ki tum meri bandagi.
Yeah. It's very beautifully done.
And when you worked with Raj Kapoor, you were the first, they say you were the first number one heroine of Hindi cinema. You created the equality between heroes and heroines. There were big heroines. There were great heroines, and you were the greatest. You worked with Bimal Roy before that. You worked with B.R. Chopra before that. You worked with Nitin Bose before that. And then when you came to Raj Kapoor, somebody of your caliber being number one, how did you manage to submit so much to another filmmaker's vision? Was that not difficult?
No, of course, I've worked with all the great film people you mentioned just now. But then everybody, you know, sort of had his own style,
yes,
his own way of, bringing out the best,
yes,
in me.
Yes.
And for this kind of a role, I thought, I couldn't have done better.
We all agree. No one can ever forget, as you said, the sophistication of Sangam,
yeah,
was something which was a new dignity, was always a part of you. Sophistication was two steps further, which we got to see.
It was not put on, you know.
Yeah, it was very
it
real.
It just came naturally. And yeah, that is why it looked so good.
Beautiful.
Because in the sense that even today when people talk of it.
Yes.
And, in my time, when I could do a number like Buddha Mil Gaya.
Got a lot very...
Can you imagine? Totally, you know,
yeah,
different.
Yeah. For the traditional
with
Indian
the tradition.
Heroine. Yeah.
And
still so dignified.
And such a novelty, you know.
Yeah.
And the whole concept was so beautiful.
Did you really enjoy it?
I did enjoy
you must have
it. Because
it
in the sense too, that, of course, there was, sort of frown and look. Because you know how, my people, my grandmother and father, they would always be there on the sets, you know, with watchful eyes and seeing that. But it became such a part of the scene.
Yes.
And it was so well conceived that it merged so well, you know, and it didn't look as if, it was just for the sake of doing something.
Absolutely.
Like taking a lampshade and putting on the head, taking the plumes and then shoving it in the hair,
right,
and then drawing the curtain and draping it around and things like that,
yes,
you know. And many people say that, your Buddha Mil Gaya. Even today, you know, they say Buddha Mil Gaya, your dance number was so good. And I feel it's so funny because it wasn't a dance at all. It was something which came very naturally. And of course, I have traveled abroad and I've seen all these in the western part of the world, and I have a fairly good idea. So with that in my mind, I did whatever he explained to me, what he wanted. And this is how it should be, and then rest of the things I said, should I do this, okay, and here and there he would give suggestions, and I did the rest.
You choreographed the song yourself?
Yeah, it was not even a choreography, as you call it. It was just whatever came, that at the spur of the moment. I couldn't have repeated.
Right.
If he had taken it
one
a second time, I couldn't have repeated
it. Oh my God.
If he had taken it again, a retake, I couldn't have repeated the same.
Mm-hmm.
So everything, it was different. Whatever came to me, I just did. Even like dancing on the small,
table.
Table. And with heels. And
I was
not even used to wearing heels,
Complimenting Buddha Mil Gaya's modernity was O Mere Sanam's dance, which is full of pathos and intensity.
Yeah.
That she's just had a fight with her.
That's right.
Respecting her.
Yes.
And did you really enjoy that dance as much, which was more your forte, being a traditional dancer?
You see, that that is a totally different, you know, yeah. I mean, you can't compare traditional dance with whatever,
modern.
You know, that's, I don't think that's quite right. Because tradition is tradition.
Yes.
And whatever I have done, you know, in my other films, my dances, traditional dances, folk dances, light dances, even you know, mixture of Western and things like that. But this had an emotional, you
Absolutely.
Know, aspect to it. And there was pathos, and at the same time, it was pleading, trying to convince him, trying to make him understand.
Yes.
So all that put together,
yes.
So I thought that was very good. And I don't know, I think I did try to do my best.
You did wonderful. And tell me, the way you speak in the film is completely different from the way you ever spoke before in any film.
The way I speak?
Speak in the film. Your intonations, you know, the
in
way
what?
You... In calling out names, you know, the way you use words in the film. Was that thought out or that was that directed as so?
In the film when I speak,
Oh
yes, that's what I said. I think I mentioned to you earlier, maybe a slightly overtone to it or slightly even a little, I mean, I would say a little exaggerated, which normally I wouldn't have done perhaps. But then he wanted it that way, you know. If he had to say something, Nahi Gopal, I would have said Nahi Gopal. He said Nahi Gopal, you know, a little more than.
But that
this is what he wanted,
magic.
And then I understood that.
Okay.
And so things worked out very smoothly.
And tell me, in costumes, who was the costume person in the film? Do you remember? Was it Bhanu Athaiya?
In Sangam. I mean, the simple costumes like, you know, saris and salwar kameez and all that, I wore whatever, you know, looked nice. And I would ask him, this is all right for the scene and thing. But then for Bhutta Mal Gaya, we took the advice of, you know, Bhanu Athaiya. Yeah.
And that white gharara you worn on the terrace.
On the terrace?
Terrace.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Who was that? That was also done by you?
Yes. That was also, you know, sort of done by me and... with my tailor, whatever I had told him to do and wanted to get that embroidered and done.
Any great happy memories of great funny memories of Sangam where you side-splitting, laughing, which rarely happens in cinema, but it just happens. Some funny memories on some song, some outro, some set. Any?
Well, I think the funniest was when I got the telegram. I thought that was very funny.
Sangam hoga ki nahi.
That started it.
That's it.
And the rest was not all fun because he being a very hard taskmaster, as I said. So it was, it used to be nice, pleasant, times very serious and of course fun. The outdoors were very good. It was real fun. We went to Paris and Venice and Switzerland,
Interlaken.
And London.
And the Rhine falls.
Rome.
Rhine falls also, they used to
that's
say.
Right.
They did some scene where Rajendra Kumar comes.
When
they meet.
Rajendra Ji,
he comes.
Comes there.
And when you look back, when Sangam achieved its great box office success, and
With two intermissions.
Again, path breaking.
I think it was running 4 hours, then they cut it and made it to about 3 hours or a little more than 3 hours.
Really?
Yeah.
And did they cut off scenes which were very dear to you? Do you remember?
No.
Nothing
just
like
all
that.
The, you know, the additional, the montage shots and scenes that were shot abroad, showing all the, you know, it was more or less like a documentary. So I think all that was cut.
So in spite of the huge box office success of Sangam, the fact that whenever we speak about you, we cannot escape Sangam, you know. The first thing one connects with you is the magic Radha of Sangam, you know. Do you feel that was your most satisfying performance?
I would say that I was very happy doing the role of Radha and that I fitted into it well and I tried to do, I mean, my best. And. But I would say it is certainly has been one of my best.
One of your best
movies.
Do you watch Sangam today?
Sangam, I mean, wherever I go,
it's
my
playing.
God, they play Sangam or they tell me about the songs, and then here in India and abroad, with my, of course, there's other films also like Ganga Jamna and Naya Daur and Sadhana and so many films like
beautiful that. Films. Kya karu ra mujhe buddha mil gaya. So many people in every decade have tried to copy it. Have you seen the copies?
I'm afraid not.
You're the original, you haven't seen the copies.
No, I haven't.
And it's never been well done, because I'm realizing, as you said, that it was spontaneously done, you know, without a choreographer, from the soul of an artist.
Like I said, I couldn't repeat that. I couldn't have repeated that myself.
So how can anyone else?
I don't know.
In the beautiful song, Dost Dost Na Raha, Pyar Pyar Na Raha, young and old alike remember that song, sing that song even today. There is an antra, a verse, which says, Safar ke vakt pe palat ke motiyo ko tolti, wo tum na thi to kaun tha, tum hi to thi. And the whole verse he has shot on a tight close-up
yes.
of yours.
It was on my face.
Face.
Yeah.
And I think for 200, 300, 400 feet, it's just capturing your face without cutting.
Without cutting, yes.
How did you manage that without blinking? Such an intense shot. Any memories?
Well, I knew it was a very intense shot, and I kept holding on. And I knew that there was going to be all that montage, you know, right on my face. And well, I till Raji said cut, I just kept holding on to that intense expression.
One take?
Just one take.
One last question. How would you like, how do you remember the director who brought out the best in you, who directed Sangam with you, who projected you and presented you as the great Radha who we can never forget? How do you remember Raj Kapoor?
Well, I would like to pay my tributes to one of the greatest outstanding filmmakers who will always be remembered, not only by the film industry, but all his fans, friends, and admirers.
And we can never forget you, the great Vaijayanti Mala. We can never forget you. So we want to thank you, ma'am. We've had this great moment to share with you. And I hope every actress who comes in the future, once in her homework, watches Sangam and sees what it is to be the great or the greatest heroine of Indian cinema. Thank you and namaste.
Namaskar.